Hello there, how are you doing? Jo Barnes here, and welcome back to another episode of Make It Happen Monday. I hope you have had a phenomenal week. And today, I wanted to talk to you because I was listening to a podcast recently. I actually listened to two podcasts by the same guy that really had such an impact on me. And I'm going to put the podcast below this video. They're both by Ryan Moran, okay? Great guy. He has a podcast called Freedom Fastlane. And he's just such a genuine, really nice guy to listen to. I love listening to his podcast. The first podcast was all about some posts that he put on Facebook and the comments he got back from those, and I'll tell you about that. And then the second podcast was an interview he did with Nick Unsworth from Life on Fire, also a very inspirational guy. So I'll put the podcast below this video, and when you get a chance, have a listen to those. But both podcasts have given me so many ideas for so many messages that I'd like to share with you on Make It Happen Monday. But the message for this week, the one that I really pulled out, particularly from the first podcast, was living for now. Really living for right now and appreciating where you are and what you've got right now. Now, bear with me here, okay? I'm not going to get too woo-woo on you, but this has had a really massive impact on my life. And the reason is, I think, is because we all set these goals, right? We all decide, and we're kind of taught to, yeah? Especially if we're in the kind of self-development age and we're really into the Tony Robbins and the Wayne Dyer and the Brian Tracy and all of that kind of stuff, you know, which I know I am, and I know many of you watching this video will be as well. We're really into that kind of self-improvement, self-development, and one of the big things that these guys talk about is setting goals and expecting more of ourselves and doing more and taking massive action and all that kind of stuff. So we kind of set all these future goals for ourselves, and we visualize where we want to be, and we do all of that, which I love and I do very regularly myself. But the challenge with that is, of course, we don't always hit the goals, do we? We don't always achieve what it is we want to achieve. In fact, more often than not, we probably don't hit our goals. You know, we as a human race, I think that we tend to over optimize. Is that the word? We're over optimistic. That's where I'm going with this. In what we believe we can achieve in a short time frame. In fact, there's a very famous quote, I believe, isn't there, which says something like we often are over optimistic on what we can achieve in a year, but under optimistic in what we can achieve in, say, 5 or 10 years. Yeah. So, and I think that's very, very true. We do. We tend to say, right, I'm going to achieve these 10 things in the next 6 months, you know, and of course, 6 months comes and goes, and you'd be lucky if you've achieved one key thing because, you know, your focus has been diverted and all that kind of stuff. But the problem is when we don't achieve our goals and when we don't get closer to where we think we want to be, we start getting disappointed with ourselves, and we start comparing ourselves to other people, which is disastrous. And I've actually done a video on comparing ourselves to other people. I'll include the link to that below this video as well. We start comparing ourselves to others who are doing really, really well. We then start getting a bit down and a bit low. Our morale gets low. We maybe lose our mojo because we feel we're not where we should be. We haven't achieved what we should have achieved. We're not as good as that person. How is it that that person is achieving all this stuff? And all these kind of self-doubts come in, you know, and we just, it can lead to total paralysis in the end, and we kind of don't move anywhere. We don't move forward at all. That's sort of the really dramatic result. The less dramatic result is that we have a look and we reassess our goals and we set a load of new ones and we kind of start all over again and we keep traipsing on, which is what a lot of us do. But this whole kind of living for right now, over the last week or so, I've been asking myself three really key questions that I want to share with you that have just had such a dramatic impact. The first question is, what am I happy about and grateful for right now, this minute? Not next week, not next year, not yesterday, not the week ago, this minute, right now. What do I really love about my life? Or what is it around me that I'm incredibly appreciative of? And it might simply be, oh, I'm loving my cup of tea that I'm drinking right now. Or I'm loving that I can look out of the window and see this amazing view. Or I love the fact that I'm able to sit here and make this video for you right now. Or I love the fact that I can cuddle my daughter. Or I love the fact that I'm in my lovely comfy bed. Whatever it is, what am I really happy and grateful for in my life at this very moment, right now? And that makes you stop. Just stop and look around you and think, okay, what am I happy about right now? And even if you're not very happy, because of the way you're wording the question in your mind, you're not asking yourself, what could I be happy about? Or what should I be happy about? Or what might I be happy about if this happened? You're literally saying, what is it? What right now am I really happy about? And you look around you and you start to think in the moment, what's making me happy now? And that can pull you from one state into another state in a second, yeah? But the challenge with that, of course, is that if we stay in just that state, what am I happy about right now? Then all of a sudden, that cheesecake's always gonna be good, isn't it? Yeah, we're gonna, oh yeah, right now I'm really happy. I'm gonna eat that cheesecake. That, oh yeah, I want that. It's gonna make me happy right now. I'm grateful for that this minute. But that cheesecake may not be moving us towards our goals. So at the same time I say that, my next question that kind of counters that but works with it, complements it, is what I'm doing right now moving me closer to my goals? Because at the end of the day, even though we want to be happy in the moment, we still want to know we're moving forward, right? We want to know we're moving towards our goals. We still want to have those goals and those visions for our future and where we want to be and who we want to be and all of that kind of stuff. So I also ask, is what I'm doing right now moving me closer to my goals? So I'm not getting rid of my goals or saying that they're not important. I'm having those two questions as complementary to each other. And then my last question, my third question I ask is, what am I doing right now that's adding value to the world? What am I doing right now that's adding value to the world? Now, you might not be doing something that's adding value every minute of the day. You might be doing something right now that's adding value to you. And that's good, because the more value you add to yourself, the more value you'll be able to give to the world. So that's okay. You might even want to change that question to, what am I doing right now to adding value, either to me or to somebody else? But you know what? What you're doing might be adding value. You might be saying, well, I'm writing a blog post and that's going to help people do this. Or I'm recording this video and that's gonna help somebody think differently. Or I'm taking a coaching call and I'm giving value to the person on the other end of the line, or whatever it is that you might be doing at that moment. So they are three absolutely fantastic questions which I'm using. Now, you can either use those exact same questions, or you can create, obviously, questions that resonate with you the most. But the key is to ask yourself at least three or four times a day, what am I happy with right now? Because we live in a constant state of future or past. We really do. We're constantly thinking about where we're going, or we're constantly thinking about where we've just been. And I really do believe that the key to true happiness is appreciating where we are right now. I really do believe that that could be a significant key to real true happiness. To just be incredibly appreciative and grateful of where we are right now. So I'll quickly tell you those three questions again. Number one, what am I really happy and grateful for in my life right now? Is what I am doing right now moving me closer to my goals? And number three, what am I doing right now to add value? Yeah, to give back, to contribute to myself, to other people around me. What am I doing right now to add value to the world is my particular question. So your challenge for this week, should you choose to accept it, is to use those questions or find your own questions and start to live for now. Okay, I'm going to put those three questions down below this video. Start to live for now. That's your challenge for this week. Ask those questions every day, a couple of times a day, so that you can really start to train your brain to start thinking about the things that you love about life this minute. Try it for a week and just see whether it helps. I mean, you might be just an amazingly happy person anyway, and that's fine, but try it for a week and see if it just heightens your awareness a little bit and makes you a little bit happier. Other than that, have a superb week. Thank you so much for watching this video this week. Come and have a chat with me in the comments box below and tell me what you think. Are you living for now? Does this resonate with you? Come and tell me how you're feeling about it. Other than that, have an amazing week. Live on purpose this week. And as always, of course, make it happen. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again next week. Take care. Bye-bye.